My granduncle did kelp trawling from wild stocks out in the banks along the coast from the 70s until the 2000s. I had this vision around kelp and seaweed, these beautiful plants dancing in the streams of water and a lot of fish around it. When I grew up, I asked them, so what can you use it for? They said, Herman, it's everything. My name is Herman Ships. We at Kelpinor are enabling the future through seaweed. We are farming seaweed to not only provide people with a nutrient-rich source of food, we want to change the world. To change the world, you really need to find a niche which is big and can become much bigger. What are the bottlenecks of this industry? What can we do to improve the sustainability, but also the efficiency of the industry?
So in this frame over there, we did an experiment where we had more dense floaters. So there's double the amount of lines in there. And what we're working on is to grow more seaweed in a smaller amount of space, which is going to be really important because locations are one of the limiting factors that we have.
In general, farming of seaweed or kelp farming is a super low-tech thing. You have to be super careful with the seedlings and with the seaweed.
If you look to the seaweed industry in Asia, it's all done by a lot of hands and a lot of workforce. The European seaweed industry is challenged.
We cannot afford to harvest a lot of times per year.
There's not technical revolution in all this work. So what we are trying to do is automate processes. We are cultivating sugar kelp, which is one of the most commonly produced seaweeds worldwide. In the production cycle, you have different seasons. In autumn, we collect fertile mother seaweed and then transfer this fertile material, the seedling material, on our ropes, our growing substrate. Then we pre-cultivate these little seedlings on our rope, usually 6 to 8 weeks in the lab, because we don't have too much light here out in the winter in Northern Norway. So we're cheating a little bit and giving them all they want in the lab. And then when they're big enough and the first sunlight is coming out again in spring, we set them out into our ocean farm.
They grow from being only 15 millimeters to over 1.5 meters in 6 months. When we had our first yield from the first batch, I had tears in my eyes. I was really proud.
Over the summer, harvesting vessels come to our farm and harvest the seaweed. We store it till we can process it.
Our innovation lies in the way that we are now upgrading the hatchery for better and more yield from the seedlings, and also having the systems for how to scale it when it comes out to the ocean. There was nothing that said that we should be able to do this other than that we really wanted to. The main focus for us now is that we need to collaborate more. We're building it step by step by step and actually being less fragmented, more oriented. We now suddenly have this group, this ecosystem for sharing ideas, problems, and of course also solutions.
One of the major problems with the climate crisis is that we're continually adding new carbon dioxide and greenhouse gases into the oceans and the atmosphere. The idea is that you can use seaweed also for carbon capture.
Kelp is a kind of plant, so it uses carbon dioxide and sunlight to produce sugars, to produce biomass, and it releases oxygen in the process. As a plant, not using land area, not using fresh water, we don't feed it, we don't use fertilizer or pesticides. It's a very sustainable plant crop.
We can use seaweed. It has so many of the building blocks for maybe even replace our use of oil to make plastics and other materials.
We are looking in the direction of enzymes or pheromones which stimulate, for example, plants to grow better. Seaweed has a lot of exactly these biostimulants in it. And if you mix it up, and spray it over our crops in the fields, they grow way better. We are looking into the next year and using a lot of our harvest for biostimulants in the European market. Being in a climate startup which has a common goal is super cool. You're not building only a company, you're building a community. We're colleagues, but we're also friends, and we want that.
This makes me motivated to work hour after hour after getting the best people and the brightest mind to work together in one direction. And for what? Well, to be able to tell our grandchildren that we actually did something. It's just going to grow and grow and grow, because curious minds, they gather together, exciting stuff will happen.